Hey everyone, Mario Madness 12 here, and welcome back to Let's Play Pikmin. I should have said welcome to the finale of Let's Play New Play Control Pikmin. In the last episode, we fought the three optional bosses, the Smoky Prog, Gulix, and Mamuta. And in this episode, we're finally going to be heading to our final trial. Well, the final trial. I don't know why I felt the need to say our final trial. Anyway, so on the fly-in, take a look at this. Crop circles. That's not what I want to point out. Because apparently, I thought you could see more of this level on the fly-in. Okay, basically, this area is the smallest area in the game, and it's going to require you to use all three colors of Pikmin. So, and you're also going to want to be really, really fast. Because the final boss can take anywhere from 5 seconds to 5 minutes, and we all know 5 minutes is about half the day, so take 10 reds, throw them on here. Whistle them, because this is a thingy of fire geysers, so only reds can get it. Might as well go into overhead view, because there's actually a 10 box here. So let's put the reds on that. They're actually not going to walk into the water when it's done, so that's smart of them. We're then going to take... They already moved the box. Let's take 15 yellows, because I think I took 30 on the previous recording of this, and that was just too many. I'm actually just going to leave them there for a little bit and take the rest out as reds. Reds? These are blues. Apparently I'm colorblind now. So let's take out 75 blues. And of course they're not all flowered. Come on, I don't want to walk too far away because you'll be stupid and then not come over to me. Okay, there we go. And let's take these guys out into the water. Okay, so once they're out here, you can actually walk them up this little ledge here. Let's not zoom the camera in. And put them on this. This bridge thingy. Apparently they want to try and break down a bomb rock wall, so let's just not have them do that. Drop them there. And let's take our yellows. I actually can't be bothered throwing them across this tiny bit of water, so I'm just going to do this and then whistle them up here. Because you can do that, so come on. There you go. It probably would have just been quicker to throw them, but whatever. So let's throw them all over there, and there's a couple of geysers, so I'm just going to take this one. And there's some bomb rocks there. If you throw the Pikmin into this tube, let's do it from overhead. Apparently they don't want to go. Throw them in there, and you'll actually get even more bomb rocks. I'm not sure how many you can get from that, but you can get a decent amount. Okay, there we go. And then let's just throw them all back over there. I'm not sure how many we got. Is that like 6 or 7? I don't know. And then let's whistle them back. And I'm not going to risk throwing them over there with bomb rocks, because I have no idea if bomb rock carrying Pikmin can swim. So I'm just going to throw them over there, call them back, split them up to bomb rock, into bomb rocks. Okay, we got 7, I was right. And apparently pick up some blues on the way. I believe this requires 6. We're about to find out. Or it requires 3. That's nice. Okay, so let's... I could have sworn that required 6. Anyway. Let's put all these guys on this little bridge. I was going to say, there's no way we've got like 20 freaking bomb rock carriers. There's a blue who didn't want to go on the wall. Come on the bridge even. So let's take these guys and put them on here. Because actually, they've nearly got that done, alright. Well, no, they haven't, there's a lie. So let's put you on there, put the one blue on there, there we go. And when we get over here, we can call the reds back. I'm not going to do it now. Because then they'll run in the water, and you'll see there's one of those walls over there. I'm actually just going to use a bomb rock Pikmin on that, because one bomb rock takes out the wall. And we're about a quarter of the way through the day, and we've already pretty much made it to the final boss, so not bad. So let's get the... God, hurry up, guys. I wish you could actually bomb rock these bridges. It would kind of make sense if you could, but... camera. But whatever. So, camera! Thank you. Okay, whistle you back. Get a bomb rock. Throw it at that. There we go. I should take that out. Indeed it does. And now let's take all our Pikmin back so we can prep for the final battle. Okay, come on. Wow, I'm doing a lot better than my previous run on this when I recorded it before. Okay, so we're not going to need any blues. So we can put all of those away. Boom. We're going to need about 25 yellows. Actually, we probably won't even need 25. I'm going to wait for the blues to go away, I don't know. We only need actually one yellow, but I take a lot of yellows just for like a precaution, I guess you could say. So let's get all those out. We've got 35 Pikmin so far, and then we're just going to get the rest out as reds, so we should have 75 reds in total. I would like it if they were all flowered, but I don't know if they're going to be. Actually, screw that, of course they are. We use the Mimuta on them. That's why it's actually a good idea to fight the Mimuta just before you go to the final trial, because you can get all of your Pikmin flowered just by walking up to it. Sure, it takes a long time to pluck them, but you get them all flowered. Also, that looks really cool. So, you see that thing there? That's your final boss. Do not go up to it. Walk around it. There's going to be another wall over here because the game feels like being a jerk and putting one there. So let's blow that up with a bomb rock. And you'll see there's actually three, I think it's three or four bomb rock holder thingies around here. So let's just get all of the yellows, most of the yellows, if not all, to have bomb rocks. By the looks of things, all of them are going to get bomb rocks. And I think it's three, actually. Bomb rock hole things. So, is that all of them? There's one guy who doesn't have a bomb rock. And there's one there, dude! There you go. Why do I only have 99 Pikmin with me? How did one get stuck down there, of all places? I'm sorry, I'm gonna have to go get him. Also, there's some yellows that didn't get bomb rockified. Come here. How in the heck did you get stuck over there, of all places? Anyway, so, let's see. I'm just contemplating how to do this. Okay, so we're going to put all of the Pikmin up here and split them up. We're then going to take one guy, throw him over there. Meet Bulblax! No. Meet Emperor Bulblax, the final boss of Pikmin. He can be really threatening if you don't know what you're doing. Pick up a freaking yellow! There. But if you know what you're doing, he's not difficult in the slightest. So let's take a bomb rock dude and put him there. He's gonna eat the bomb rock dude. The bomb rock's gonna explode in his face. I was gonna say on his face, in his face. And then we just take all the reds and throw them at his face. Leave them on for as long as you can before whistling them off so you can get even more damage on him. You are gonna lose a few Pikmin in this fight, namely yellows with bomb rocks. Let's put two back. And he's actually really stupid sometimes and doesn't even notice you. So you gotta get his attention. Then, as I've learned, when you get his attention, that's when you want to drop your bomb rock dude, because otherwise he doesn't eat the bomb rock dude and he just sits there looking at it. Okay, call you back. Oh god, that jump can actually be really deadly. Yeah, that tiny little jump can be what kills most of your Pikmin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, that's all of you. Come here. Dude, there. Okay, come at me, Bulblax! It's Emperor Bulblax. I need to stop calling him Bulblax. I might as well just call him Cloud Cooper or Blue Tanuki, I don't know. Come on. I also haven't called these reds Billy throughout the whole thing, which I said I was gonna do. Alright, so throw like hell! You can probably hear my nunchuck! Throw like hell! Oh god, I didn't mean to switch the camera around there. Oh, did he kill one? No he didn't, okay. He did deflower a couple of them, but I don't want to put them inside that. That's what she said. Yeah, so this boss is not difficult. It can just take a hell of a long time to beat. And that can be your main problem, because you may not have time to get the ship part back in time. And if you want to do this all in one day, you kind of have to get the ship part back in time as well. So that can be kind of annoying. Okay, whistle them off there. You can just throw reds on him like that when he's just walking around without stunning him, but honestly, I'm not going to do that because there's a hell of a high risk that you're going to lose a load of reds by doing that. Come at me, bro. Come at me, bro. Come at me, bro. Here, have dinner. I kept calling the bomb rock dudes dinner in my previous recording of this. Anyway, I cannot believe that we're already at the finale of Pikmin. This has gone really quick. I mean, I know Pikmin was evidently going to be a small LP, but I wasn't expecting it to take this little amount of time. So, come here. I say that, I probably started it God knows how long ago, but... Dude, come and look at my yellow bomb. My yellow wither bomb. There you go. Or do that. See, he just completely just doesn't even notice him. Dude, I'm right here in front of you. I appreciate you have really stupid... I'm not even going to let you have him that. You're looking the wrong freaking way. Come here. I'm over this way. Oh my god, he's so stupid. There. Reds. Come on, let's just kill this stupid thing. I swear, Emperor Bulblax is ridiculously dumb. He didn't even notice it. It's like when you have a cat and you give it a piece of meat and it drops it, and then it takes 10 minutes to find the piece of meat that's right next to it. I don't know why I felt like bringing that up of all things, but it just felt like an apt analogy. Okay, come on. Also, the music's supposedly tense, but oh god, there we go. He's doing his pretty much only attack other than eating Pikmin, which is just jumping around. Oh look, you're gonna jump again. Oh god, that's so threatening. Go on, jump again. Oh, I can see you on my camera. Here. Oh, jump again. That works too. Come on, come on, come on. This is a really awkward place for you to be. Debba-debba-da. He's so stupid, he doesn't even notice me when I walk straight in front of him. He's gonna jump again, isn't he? Isn't this just wonderful? As you may have guessed, if he lands on a Pikmin, it's insta-death for it, but so far we've only lost 6, and that's just Bomb Rock dudes. Oh my god, come here. There you go. I'm hoping we can take him out in this one go. I doubt we can, but it would be nice. A tip for you. Did he just, like, fall over? A tip for you. When he's eating the Bomb Rock Pikmin, do not start throwing your other Pikmin onto him, because... Did he kill some? Overrun, guys! Okay, now they're dead. Because the explosion caused by the Bomb Rock inside his mouth comes out of his nose, pretty much, and that can actually damage your Pikmin and kill them, so... That's wonderful. We've only actually... Oops. Don't do that. Here you go. Honestly, there's a way to do this without losing your yellows, obviously, but... It's just so much easier just to let your yellows die, pretty much. It's kind of harsh because they've helped us this whole time, but it's the best way to do it. Guys, don't even go after him. God, he looks so ridiculous. Okay, come back. I'm hoping we're going to do this in time. It'd be nice. Okay, go over there. Turn around. You're on the a tiny little slither of HP. It would be nice if you didn't just jump. And, oh god, come on, dude. If you make me miss out on getting the final ship part back on this day because you're stupid. Come here, come on. Oh my god. Here, dinner. No, I thought he was going to miss it then. Go! Throw like hell. Yes, did it. And there's the final ship part. It's not a ship part at all. It's a piggy bank.
At long last, I found the final part, my secret safe, and it's as full as ever. How glad am I that I persisted in my search without losing hope. Now I can leave this planet without any regrets. Maybe I'll even stop and pick up some souvenirs for my wife and kids back on planet Hokotate.
And Thingy-ma-bobby sinks into the ground. And let's take some pellets. Actually, screw that. We don't need Pikmin because this is the final day. What the hell am I on about? Let's just take the ship part back. And if we have any Pikmin left over, we can take a pellet, but we don't have enough because they're all carrying Bomb Rocks. I believe 75 is the maximum you can have on that. Oh, that guy's alone. He doesn't have a Bomb Rock, so let's give him one. Have a Bomb Rock. There you go. I bet he's really happy now. He can die happy because he knows that Olimar let him have a Bomb Rock in the final day. Anyway, so that's... Gonna be back, and at the end of that, it's pretty much gonna be cutscenes until the credits, so... Yeah. I'd like to thank you guys for watching Pikmin. Obviously, I'll talk through the credits for a bit, but... Thank you guys for watching Pikmin, and let's get the final ship part back to the Dolphin and escape from the Pikmin planet forever. Well, not really forever, but you know.
I finally recovered every ship part. Now I can return home to Hokotate.
Thank you.
There we go! Wow. That was apparently my third best day, even though I got 30 that second is when I completed it before. And surviving Pikmin 759, second best, and total Pikmin lost, is actually only my third worst, holy crap. Second worst, not third worst. Total Pikmin ever sprouted, 4,912. There's the final analysis. Let's go to the credits. Actually, screw that. Ship parts. Those five blue ones at the end there, those are the not required ones because you don't need a rubber ring to fly a spaceship. But there's all the ship parts. And, well, there you go. That's all I can say, really. There's all the ship parts. And now, with this awesome music, it's going to take us to the credits. Wii Edition staff credits, because they felt the need to write Wii Edition on there. Satoru Iwata, Shigeru Miyamoto, as you would have guessed. Honestly, this LP has been amazing. Pikmin is one of my favorite games of all time. And we get a little flashback here of the first ever cutscene in the game where Olimar gets hit by that meteorite, falling down to the Pikmin planet. I have loved doing this LP, and I don't know if you guys have quite clicked with this or whatever, if you know what I'm on about. A while ago I mentioned I'm gonna LP a load of games. Basically what I mean by that is I really want to do, just like on my channel, I kind of want to change the direction I'm doing my channel. I will probably make a video about this separately. Basically I just want to LP an absolute ton of games. I don't want to have to stick to much of a schedule. I mean, obviously, I have been doing with Pikmin and Wreck-It Ralph. But basically, the idea is, I may even LP the GameCube version of Pikmin in the future. I'll probably do it with a co-commentator because I've already LP'd this game as you're watching it now. But I will quite possibly LP the GameCube version of this game in the future. Maybe it's a bit of a challenge because I'm not as good at the GameCube one. But yeah, that's basically what I mean, and hang on, I'm trying not to sneeze. This game, Pikmin, especially the Wii version, is one of the best games I think ever made. I just dropped my nunchuck. I love the game, I love the way it plays out, I love the Pikmin, I love Olimar, and yeah, so I'm just going to leave you guys to the credits. There's actually, I guess, two lots of credits in this, but I'm just going to leave you guys to the credits for now, and screw that. The freaking PVR just cut out in the credits, are you serious? Hang on. I am so sorry for that. The PVR cuts out in the credits of all places. And there we go. Now, enemy roll call. And he just got squished by the armored cannon beetle. This is basically going to stay all of the enemy, show you all of the enemies and, for example, pellet posies and stuff within the game. You may see this is actually footage from the GameCube game, because Olimar's pointer is a bit smaller and it's actually fixed a certain distance in front of him. But other than that, there's just a couple of things I'm going to point out about this before I just leave. There's actually some areas shown in this enemy roll call which aren't actually in the game. There's an example when it shows the Guliks, and you can see that the bridges in the background look a bit different. At one point it shows the Guliks in the Distant Spring, but the Guliks never appears in the Distant Spring. There's also a few other areas, for example this. This is the Distant Spring, but there's never a blue candy pot bud there. Basically, it also shows some beta stages, or what I assume to be beta stages. Let's see if the next one is one. That's a beta stage, because where the hell is that? But basically, the other thing is the Swooping Snitch Bug is out of order. These are all in alphabetical order, but the Swooping Snitch Bug just randomly appears earlier on. And the final thing I want to mention is, you know, Wallywogs? In the European version, they're called Wallyhops. That's it. So I'm going to leave you guys to the enemy roll call and the awesome music, and see you guys at the end of the credits. Okay, apparently they're called Walpoles in the European version. And there's your Wallyhops, because that's a stupid name. Go back and watch the bit where it shows the Sheerwig. There's a bread bug just like pedo-bearing in the background. Also, there's never a Bulbob over there in that level. I don't think there's ever even a Bulbob in the Distant Spring. A spotty Bulbob. But yeah, credits. The credits are almost over. Sorry once again that it cut out and it faded to black. And with some flowers, the happy end. As the game is implying here, there's actually a bad end and an okay end to the game. The bad end is basically if you don't collect enough ship parts, and the okay end is if you collect all of the required ship parts. So yeah, it just went to the end by itself. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Oh, by the way, I'm going to be recording those endings and putting them in bonus videos. Thank you guys for watching. There's the title screen one more time. And I'll see you guys in the bonus videos. Actually, no, I won't. But I'll see you guys. Bye.